was successful.
Oh, okay.
My OBS cut out weirdly.
Oh, okay.
Me see if it's let's see if it's back online.
DG said it's back.
Okay, I think everyone just needs to refresh then. Yeah, looks like refreshing. Sounds like we're back. Okay, she says it's back.
Can you reshare your screen on Discord? I think
Yeah,
it that went.
did that cut out too? Might have been
Yeah.
my internet just going then. Sorry about that, everyone. I thought it was a OBS connection issue because it said that the OBS connection had gone. I don't know if we missed something here with the Bears Kingpins, but just wanted to make sure that the batting order and the pitching, or sorry, the box score in general was shown, as well as the player of the game. Make sure that everyone sees that. I did go through it. I don't know if it went through before the stream went down, but if it didn't, here we go. This is the final information for the Brew City Chicago game.
Last Miners game of the day, the Dillos took down the Wheelers. For the Dillos, it was Steve Rogers who went 1 for 3 with 2 RBI, and Milot hit 2 home runs and got 4 RBIs. Over on the Wheeler side, it looks like multi-hit games from Hunts Catsup and Sudot, who went 2 for 3 with 2 RBIs. Pitching side of things, it was Baxter taking the loss, giving up 7 earned runs. Roshi got the win, giving up 5. And Thomas got the save, their second of the season. Player of the game is Malott for their 2 home run performance.
That'll do it for May 18th. I'll finish with both the majors and the minors, and we're going to go ahead and finish and move on to May 19th. No majors games. Taking a look down at the minors, though, we do have 5 games to look at. This is a quick sim day. The last primetime game will be broadcast for May 20th. So we're going to go ahead and autoplay all the games today, and we'll start off with the 66ers versus the Lemurs. San Bernardino will take this one 5-1, improving to 18-6 on the season. It looks like a 4-for-4 game by Maxto Poutine on the side of the Lemurs, the only multi-hit game and the only RBI accredited to the first baseman. San Bernardino has a 2-for-4 game for miles ahead with 3 RBIs. And Jackie Daytona, 1-for-3 game, crossing the plate twice. Bat and Bougie also tacks on 2 RBIs as well. Grimes gets their third win of the season for San Bernardino. Chloe McCarthy gets the save. Matt Prisivka gets the loss for the Lemurs. And Robert Grimes is your player of the game.
Next up, Bears Kingpins. Kingpins will come out on top here with the victory. On the Bears batting order, no multi-hit games, but RBIs from Sosa and Fabian for the Kingpins. Leadoff hitter Chris Jacob was 3 for 3 with 3 runs scored. And Pork Sandwiches, 1 for 3 with 3 RBIs. Looks like he had a 2-run triple. For the pitching side of things, it was Boyd Jr. taking the loss, giving up 3 earned runs in 5 innings. And Lanzador picked up the win with a quality start, 6 1/3, 2 earned. And Kingpin with 2 2/3 scoreless innings. Chris Jacob is the player of the game.
Taking a look at the Hepcats Mounties game. Hepcats are going to win this one 6-4. Despite the Kingston Mounties out hitting them 10-8. Mounties fall to 6-18 on the season. Hepcats rise to 14-10. 4 RBI game for Ernie Witt, the catcher out of Kansas City, going 2-for-3. Weedon Boy is going 2-for-4 and crossing the plate twice. Junichi Kaneda with a couple of RBIs as well on the side of Kansas City. Kingston has a couple of RBIs from Anita Fardinghouse on the top of the order there, and multi-hit games from Mike Boss Jr., Zach Washington, and Rob Worth. Looks like Master is going to get the loss, Glizzy Master, on the side of Kingston, their second of the season. Jack Brady is going to get the win for Kansas City, improving to 2-2, and Ernie Witt is going to be your player of the game.
Next game, Dynamos and Swift Steeds. Dynamos take the win 9-5 for the Swifties on the batting side. Jimmy Smith went 2-for-5, and Hussey and Blamo both picked up two knocks, with Blamo having two RBIs. For the Dynamos, Jebediah Kronk went 3-for-5 with two runs scored, and Krustis went 1-for-4 with two RBIs. The loss went to Sideaway, who gave up 7 3 innings of work. And the win went to Simile, who went 2 1/3 and gave up 3, but he qualified for the win. Player of the game is Vladimir Bodnar. Not sure what he did. I think it said he had a RBI double. Home run. Yeah, so he had a home run. Yeah, and a double.
Just the home run, it looks like. 1-for-1, 2 RBI home run, and 3 walks for Bodnar. Wheelers will take down the Dillos here, 12-2. Blowout here for Anchorage. Out-hitting Amarillo, 15-7. 4 RBI game for a cardboard cutout of Derek Jeter, going 3-for-4 on the day. Will Fisher, the left fielder, with 3-for-5. With a 3-for-5 game, Fazio 3-for-4, Hunt's Cats Up, excuse me, 2-for-4 with 3 runs, Diamondo with a pair of RBIs at the top as well, Hickoms going 3-for-4, down in the pitching, Freddie Huff takes their first loss of the season, Velasquez gets their third win of the season for Anchorage, and a cardboard cutout of Derek Jeter is going to be your player of the game. That's going to do it for the 19th. So we finish up both the minors and the no games majors. We're going into the 20th, and we'll be looking at primetime game number 3 of the day, number 7 overall. It's the Apex and the Vandals. I don't know if anyone's in the chat that can put a prediction up, but while we're looking at the matchups here, which it looks like the Vandals have the advantage 6-4 here. Apex have it at the 3, the 5, and the 9 spot, and the pitching. I'm going to take a look at some of the info that the stat team has given us. Thank you, stat team, for all the work that you do. For the Vandals, Emilia Takahashi is starting. Emilia is 1-2 with a 5.76 ERA. With a 6.85 FIP, Takahashi seems to be getting lucky, which is not a positive for the Vandals. You Need to Calm Down is 1-2 with a 4.85 ERA. Those past 2 years have seen him pitch to a 2.08 ERA, so he might be heating up at the right time. The Apex offense is led by Rick Hood and Jameis Winston. Hood is playing Gold Glove caliber D with 2.7 UZR in 20 games, while Winston has a 1.106 OPS and an incredible 9 home runs. At age 35, Winston is off to the hottest start of his career. The Vandals' offense ranks 13th in the league, and their only strength at this point is their speed. With 22 steals, they rank 6th in the league. This is the first meeting between the two teams this season. Technically, the second, I believe, since I think this is the second game of the series, but the first, this series is the first meeting of these two teams for sure. I think the Vandals actually won the previous game of the series, so we'll see if the Apex can come back or the Vandals can put a 2-0 start to the three-game set. How many home runs this game do you all think? Is it going to be over or under 2.5? 3 or more or 2 or less? You got 13 more seconds to try and get your channel points towards one or the other, either the over or the under, and we'll be keeping an eye out for that threshold. Wow, that just spiked towards the over right at the end there. It was under for it was very strongly under for a while, and it just spiked to the over. So 54% say under 2.5, 46% say over 2.5. What do you think, Red?
I'm liking the over here. I'm seeing Jameis Winston 9 home runs on the season. And a lot of power in both these lineups, and some higher ERAs. So we'll see how that combination, see what that looks like.
We shall see indeed. Do you want to take us do you want to take the apex on this
Sure.
one?
Yeah,
While I
I
take
can
a
I'll take
while I take my
the
Vandals.
apex here.
All right, we'll get on into game and see where we're at on the home run counter at the end of the game.
So Rick Hood will lead off this game as he up with a full count, and he will draw a leadoff walk. Next up is Maggio Cuomo, who will hit this ball deep field, but a few steps short of the warning track, not quite getting that first home run on the board yet. Bend over will tap one to the pitcher, who goes to second, and that's the only out they're going to get. Jameis Winston here, 9 home runs on the season, but he swings and misses here. So no hits for Indianapolis in their first half of the inning as we swing it to the bottom of the first inning.
Sack Lodge, the catcher, is going to be up first for the Vandals against You Need to Calm Down. That's going to be a strikeout going down on three pitches. It'll be Herb Sessions coming to the plate next. The shortstop is going to go down on strikes as well. Two strikeouts back to back to start the game for You Need to Calm Down. It's going to be Zach Mouse, the left fielder, now stepping into the box. And that's going to be striking out the side. You Need to Calm Down says to the Vandals offense, you need to calm down. Striking out the side to start the game in the bottom of the first here.
Apex back at the plate, and that is a line drive base hit for Sir Javier Dominguez Jr. But he gets picked off at first. So that baseman immediately gets wiped out, and then Johnny's tsunami grounds out to the first baseman, and Jimbo Slice will strike out looking. So a rare pickoff there for Takahashi, and it's still 0-0 as we go to the bottom of the second.
It's going to be the heart of the order for the Vandals. Toby McMuffin first up. High fly ball into right center. That won't be enough to put the first home run on the board for the predictions. Lunchbox McGrath is going to go down on strikes. That's four strikeouts now and five outs. Four to calm down. It's going to be Geronimo Scheidermey, the second baseman. Liner into left field. That's going to be a base hit. That's going to be the Vandals' first hit of the ball game against Uni, as Scheidermey at first is going to make his way all the way to third on the double by Bob Gibbles. No, Scheidermey is going for the plate, and he's going to score at the plate. Everyone's hoping for the long ball, but the Vandals are playing small ball as Bob Gibbles with an RBI double to put the Vandals onto the board here, 1-0. Sam Andrews will go down on strikes. As they leave a runner on, but the Vandals will strike first here. 1-0, top of the third coming up.
Big Chungus will ground this one in the second baseman for the first out of the inning. And now Sailor Twift hits that ball deep into right field. Is it deep enough? It is not.
Oh.
Just missed going over that fence. And a line drive to the left fielder from Rick Hood will end the inning. So Indy not yet on the board, and they just missed that first home run of the game.
Danny Gonzalez, the center fielder, is going to be up first for the Vandals, and that's going to be a quick ground out to third, out number one here in the bottom of the third. Zach Lodge, fly ball into right field. Not enough juice, though. It's going to be taken care of by the right fielder, Mangiacomo. Sessions with a liner into right. That's going to get past Mangiacomo for a base hit. Sessions on his way to third. He's going to be safe miles ahead of the throw. And the Vandals have a runner 90 feet from the plate for the left fielder, Zach Mouse. And that's going to be a base hit. Vandals are going to strike again on the small ball. That's going to be a 2-0 lead now for the Vandals here in the third off of You Need to Calm Down. Toby McMuffin, though, is going to line it to the shortstop. Incredible catch by Hood. And the Vandals will put another run on the board here in the third as we get to the top of the fourth now. Apex looking to strike back.
And that's a diving stop by the third baseman, Andrews, but not quick enough to get the out. And there's a ball hit deep into right field. And that one is gone. So this game is tied at two with a home run from Bend Over, and that's the first home run of the game.
We're at one for the
So,
predictions.
Getting on board there for the over. Line drive from James Winston will be caught for the first out of the inning. Another ground ball to the third baseman. This one will be retired from Dominguez Jr. And Johnny Tsunami will hit one into the right field gap, and he will look for a second, and he will cruise into second, standing up for a two-out double. And now Jimbo Slice with two outs will tap that one to the pitcher, and that will end the inning. But Bend Over with the two-run bomb will tie it at two as we head to the bottom of the fourth.
It's going to be McGrath, Scheidermay, and Gibbles due up against to come down. And McGrath is going to go down on strikes to start this one out. You know, we're in the bottom of the fourth here. Tie game at 2-2. Only one home run on the board, and that's going to roll all the way down to the corner. That one was holding on to the right foul line for a while there, as Scheidermay winds up with a double. I believe that's the second base hit of the game. And on a passed ball, I believe, or a wild pitch, Scheidermay will advance to third. Gibble's going to knock him in again, and Gibbles is going to get his second RBI double of the game. Scheidermay scoring from third easily. Vandals are back up in the lead 3-2 now as Sam Andrews takes the free pass to first base. First and second now with one out as Danny Gonzalez, the center fielder, going down on strikes for out number two. It's going to be the top of the order. Sack Lodge, the catcher, with runners at first and second, two away. Base hit into center. And juice is based. Base is juiced for Herb Sessions, the shortstop. And that's going to be a base hit into right field. And that's going to score two. Safe at home is Sam Andrews. Two-run single by Herb Sessions, and the Vandals increase their lead 5-2. I was kind of hoping for a grand slam for the predictions, but Zach Mouse is going to get a base hit, and that's going to be a two RBI double potentially. Yeah, looks like he might have had a play at the plate, but the Vandals will tack on another two on a two-run double by Zach Mouse. 7-2 now the score, and it's Toby McBuffin grinding to shortstop, and mercifully the inning is over. It looks like Noah Sleeping came in at the end there. So the Vandals tack on five in the bottom of the fourth to make it a 7-2 ball game going to the top of the fifth.
So the Apex will have some work to do here, but looks like a good start as Big Chungus hits one to the left field wall for a leadoff double. So, and now Sailor Twift up, and that ball will drop. So runners on the corner here for the top of the order with no outs. Rick Hood will ground one, and that will be a 5-4-3 double play. So a run scores, but two outs, I'm sure the Vandals will take that. And Maggio Como will ground this one to the shortstop. So the Apex do add a run, but they still trail by four as we head to the bottom of the fifth.
It's going to be Lunchbox McGrath up to bat here, and that's going to be ground out to third base. That's going to be out number one as Scheidermay steps into the box. Gunner first, and that's out number two. Bob Gibbles is up next, and that's going to be ground out to second for out number three. And that will put the Apex back up to bat as we go to the top of the sixth now.
Lead off walk to Bend Over. And now Jameis Winston up to bat, and that is a ground ball to the shortstop. They get one, but the second baseman has trouble with the throw. And a one-out walk to Dominguez Jr. will set up two on for Johnny Tsunami. He grounds one softly to the first baseman, who has to just go to first. And Jimbo Slice with a base hit. That'll score one, the second one in, and he will be safe. So a two-run single by Jimbo Slice cuts the deficit in half. And the check swing, and they will say he went around, and that will end the inning. But two runs for the Apex make it a two-run ball game.
Bottom of the sixth now. Vandals looking to extend their lead with Sam Andrews up to bat, and that one is gone! Home run for Sam Andrews. Is that number two on the game so far?
I think it
I
is.
believe that's number two, so we're right at the threshold now. Next home run will be the over, but Sam Andrews, 395 feet, puts the Vandals a little bit further ahead, 8-5 now. Danny Gonzalez, the center fielder, high fly ball into right center, doesn't have quite the juice on it that Andrews did, but he's going to drop it in center field. That's going to go as an error, and Gonzalez is going to get to first, but will be thrown out at second on the double play ball by Zach Lodge. Herb Sessions will go down on strikes, so the Vandals get one off the home run by third baseman Sam Andrews, but they can't get anything else as they extend the lead 8-5, going to the top of the seventh now.
Jake Plummer in now for the Vandals. He will start his outing off with a walk to the nine-hole hitter, but will come back with a strikeout to the shortstop, Rick Hood. And now one on for Magiacomo, who will l bend over, will draw a walk. That ball's crushed, though,
Oh.
from Winston,
Ooh.
but he didn't quite get all of it, and the center fielder Gonzalez will put it away. So, still only two home runs, and the Apex still trail by three as we head to the stretch.
Vandals legend Jake Plummer. Yeah. It's going to be Zach Mouse off the bat here in the bottom of the seventh, and he's going to get issued a free pass. Eric Bolanos on the mound now. Toby McMuffin will go down on strikes. Runner at first, one away for Lunchbox McGrath, the DH. Grounder to short, and they can't make a play. It's going to be first and second now for Scheidermey. He's going to go down on strikes for out number two, and Bolanos' second strikeout. Bob Gibbles, already with a bunch of hits. This one is going to get another RBI double. I believe that's his third RBI double today, and it's going to bring home two. It looked like they had another shot at the plate there, but that's going to be a 10-5 lead for the Vandals. Looks like Gibbles also tied a record, too. We'll take a look at that in box score. But a ground out to third by Sam Andrews will end the inning. So Vandals put another two on the board. 10-5 now. Bats are waking up for Vancouver. Top of the eighth coming up.
Plummer's still in here now, and he will induce a ground ball from Javier for the first out of the inning. Next up, Johnny Tsunami swings and misses for strike three, and now Jimbo Slice comes up to bat with two outs, looking to do some damage here. That is through past the shortstop for a base hit with two outs. And now Big Chungus up to bat, and he will swing and a miss. It was Dave Mann in there with the strikeout. And so now we head to the bottom of the eighth, and the Vandals are still up 10-5.
Bottom of the eighth, Vandals have a chance to extend the lead. Danny Gonzalez going to get on strikes. That's going to be out number one. And we'll go back to the top of the order here. Zach Lodge. Slow grounder to the left side, and that's going to buy him enough time to get through first base. Infield hit for Zach Lodge. Dogwood Maple coming in to pitch now and is going to immediately make their presence known, striking out the veteran Herb Sessions. Zach Mouse grounds it to second base, thrown on to first, and that's going to be out number three. So the Vandals get a runner aboard with a hit, but no runners across the plate. It's still 10-5 as we get to the top of the ninth. Apex have one last chance for it.
And the inning will be led off by Sailor Twift, who hits a pop-up to the right fielder for an easy first out. Next up is Rick Hood, who will go down on strikes. So now down to their last chance. It is Magiocomo. And he hits this one again to the right fielder, but that
Oh, he dropped it.
looked like he dropped it. So, and now another shot to the right fielder, but he will catch this one.
Okay.
So the Vandals come out on top 10-5 here.
McMuffin scared me there. You want to take this one?
Sure. So, 10-5 win for the Vandals. They're doing pretty well this season, 16-7. For the offense, Bend Over went yard for the Apex, and Jimbo Slice had two RBIs going 2-for-4. For Vancouver, Herb Sessions was 2-for-5 with two RBI, and Zach Mouse, the co-GM, 2-for-4 with three RBI. The loss goes to the Indianapolis starter. You need to calm down. Gave up seven and 3 2/3. And Takahashi gets the win, giving up 5 5 2/3. And Jay Plummer with the hold, going 2 shutout innings. Player of the game is Bob Gibbles. He did set a record. I think we mentioned that earlier. He tied the regular season game record with 3 doubles in a game.
Yeah, so the under is going to be the prediction there, as Sam Andrews and Ben Dover rear 2 home runs of the game, just barely at the threshold there. As we look around the league, though, Aviators continue to have a great start to the season here, 19-4 now, as they take the win over the New York Voyagers, going 6-2 the final. 4-for-5 game for Stevenson with 2 RBIs on the side of the Voyagers and a multi-hit game from Rivers, but that's about it in the lineup for New York. On the side of Outer Banks, 3-for-5 for Izzy DeAlesio with 2 RBIs. Farley Hank with a multi-hit game, 2-for-4 across on the plate twice, and a 2-for-5 game for Hunter Geist. Smash Jackson gets the win for Outer Banks with Farron Benkaiden getting a hold and Jose 43 getting their 7th save of the season. Fumikage Tokuyami is going to get their 2nd loss of the season for New York, and Joshua Stevenson will be your player of the game in the losing effort for the Voyagers.
Next up, the Supernovas down the Toros, 12-8. Red Arrow, 4-for-5 with 2 RBI and 3 runs scored. Good day for the leadoff hitter. Also, a 2-for-5 and 2 RBI performance from Sandy Taters and 3 RBIs for Bridget Westfall. For Cancun, Peter LaFleur, 1-for-4 with 3 RBIs, and Ace Carter and Bauer both hit a home run. Over on the pitching side of things, Pat Rogers picked up the win, going 3 1/3 shutout innings, and Maddox and McQuack both picked up holds. The loss went to the starting pitcher, Lemon, who gave up 7 2 2/3. Player of the game, Red Arrow. So both of us streamers having player of the games this stream.
Crazy. Death Valley Scorpions are going to fall to the Detroit Demons. Both teams now at 12-11 on the season. 4-1 is the final score, despite 8 hits for both teams. 2 RBIs for Victor Herrera at the top of the Demons batting order. Revin Knox, 2-for-3. Danny B and Joe Burrow also with multi-hit games. Joe Burrow tagging on a RBI as well. 1-for-4 game for Orem with 1 RBI, the only RBI on the side of the Scorpions. 3-for-4 game for Fulman and 2-for-4 for Alderson. Shane Green gets their 4th loss of the season. 6 innings, 3 runs given up. Striker spin rate gets their 4th win for the Demons, 5.1 with only 1 run given up. Vaughn and Galvin both get holds for Detroit, and Striker spin rate will be your player of the game.
Next up, the Crabs upset the Rougarous 5-3 in 12 innings.
It was tied at 1.
6 runs in that last inning.
It was tied at 1 going into the 12th.
For Providence, Marcus Reeves went 3-for-5, and Rusty Koontz went 2-for-5 with 2 RBI. For the Rougarous, Richie Bonanza went 4-for-6 with 3 RBIs. Pretty much the entire New Orleans offense there. Over on the pitching side of things for Providence, it was Tachi Bana getting the start and going 6, giving up 1 earned run. The win went to Farias, going 2 1/3, giving up 1. And the loss went to Tommy Mazeroski, who only retired 1 batter and gave up 4 runs, 2 earned. Player of the game on the losing side of things is Richie Bonanza.
Raptors will take down the Sloths here, 9-8, close game. It was tied at 7 going into the 10th. Raptors scored 2 and were able to hold the Sloths to just 1 in the bottom of the 10th. 15-12 on the hitting. That's going to be a big hitter's day. Lots of relievers used, I expect. Bobby McDonald, 4 for 5 on the day for the San Antonio Sloths, crossing the plate twice and knocking in three. Christy Abbott also knocks in three, going 2 for 5. Multi-hit games as well for Turtle and Dinkle. On the side of Boise, 4 for 6 game for Steve Iso with 2 RBIs. Finn Reese, 2 for 5 with 2 RBIs. Chyson Boone getting a couple of RBIs as well. Connor McDavitt, 3 for 5. Toot Blonde also 2 for 5 at the bottom of the order, scoring twice. So bats all around. Walter White gets the win for Boise, improving to 2-1 on the season, going 3 innings in relief, giving up only a run. Potato gets the save for the Raptors. Esteban Rodriguez Jr. gets the loss and the blown save for San Antonio, going 2 innings in relief. Bobby McDonald, your player of the game, and Stan Antonio ties the Sloths' regular season game record for walks with 4, right there at the top of the order.
Last game of the day, Kashima beats Nashville,
Oh.
7-6. For Kashima, multi-hit game for Julio Ruiz and Benito Alomar, and 4 RBIs for Valor.
Grand Slam.
Yeah, Grand Slam. For Nashville, multi-hit game for Hopman. It went blurry on me, but I saw three other names, I think, with 2 hits.
Yeah, Buswell, Fry, and Philly Fan for Nashville.
Yeah. For the pitching, it was Leaf picking up the win, giving up 2 5 2/3, and Silas Young picking up the save. El Charro took the loss, giving up 7 6 1/3. The starter Ivy Leaf is the player of the game.
That's going to do it for the majors. We'll head on down to the minors and take a look there. No games for the minors on the 20th. We'll go ahead and finish up today and go to the 21st. We're done with primetime games, but we have two other games that we're going to be showing you. First one being the Supernovas versus the Cancun Toros, right about here. There we are. Supernovas versus the Toros. Looks like a fairly even matchup on the matchups here. Tie in the cleanup position. Toros have the advantage in 2, 3, 5, and 8. Supernovas everywhere else. So it looks like a slight edge to the Supernovas. Get some stats here for you. Nacho Vargas pitching for the Toros. He's 1-3 with a 5.40 ERA in 5 starts. Buster Nutt is pitching for Sarasota, and he is 0-4 with a 6.83 ERA in 5 games, yet to throw a quality start. Cancun still has several productive players guiding them through their rebuild. Tilapia Sammons II is hitting .284 with 4 homers and 1.1 WAR. He's 4 runs away from 500, and it's possible he reaches this milestone tonight. He is also sitting on 445 RBI, so he could hit his 450th RBI total. Don't know where he's at currently. Unfortunately, this is written before the stream, so not quite sure if he's already hit that 450th RBI, but we'll take a look maybe. Sarasota ranks 13th in runs with 72 and 13th in ERA with a 5.64 ERA at 6-14. Their Pythag is second to last in the league. Cancun has won both of their games so far against Sarasota. Let's see, can we get Tilapia Sammons? I want to see if he's hit his 450th yet. Don't actually know how to see the total. Oh, history probably. Maybe not. Batting stats? Oh, here we go. Career. No, he's still at 445 RBI. So unless he gets 5 RBIs here, I'm not quite sure if he'll hit 450 in this game. Who knows? He could. Maybe a grand slam and a solo shot, but we'll take a look. Everyone, take a look at that prediction as you got 25 seconds left. How many total hits over under is 15.5? Do you think they'll get 16 or more hits, or do you think they'll get 15 or fewer hits? Go ahead and tell us in that predictions. You got 11 seconds left.
Batter to note, Bogaskew's 9 for 18 with 4 home runs against Varga.
Ooh, that's some good stats right there for Bogaskew. Eddie's hot hitting right now too, so this could be a really big game for the co-GM of Sarasota, the QJ. Looks like total hits. Most of you say over at 53% to 47%. So we'll see if this is a big hitting game. keep screwing the odds at the last second. Well, we'll see whether it's the over or the under as we take you into the ball game. Why don't you start us off with your batter at the plate?
Red Arrow will start off the game here with a 2-2 count. Pitch. And that ball is hit
Wow.
well. And a leadoff home run. That was crushed. So very quickly getting on the board. I know at least one person in the chat has me on their fantasy team, so
That
that'll help.
was a no doubter.
Second batter up, Carlos Crashwagon will ground out to the second baseman for the first out of the inning. And Bogaskew.
Oh!
and that is gone, another home
Wow.
run. We mentioned his hot hitting against Varga, and that'll continue today.
Yeah. Both GMs hitting a home run at the top of the first.
Over people are feeling good right now. Torrent will hit a ball to the shortstop for the second out of the inning, and Taters will do the same. But two solo shots from both the GMs put the Sarasota Supernovas up 2-0.
Michael Fitted will lead off for the Toros. They're already down 2-0 as Nutt takes the mound. And that's going to be a base hit into left field. Ooh, my sim just went really wonky there. It'll probably show up on the stream. But Fitted winds up at second with a double. Tilapia Salmon's high fly ball into right field, but it's caught. Caught by Bogaskew. And Fitted will advance to third, though, on the sac fly. Cutter goes down on strikes, so it's two outs with a runner 90 feet from the plate for Anthony Bauer, the first baseman. That's going to be grounder short over to first, and that's going to be out number three as Panda takes care of that one. Throwing on to Taters. Still 2-0 as we go to the top of the second now. Supernovas have a chance to extend that lead.
Westfall will start off the inning with a ground ball to the right side of the pitcher's mound that'll be thrown out. And there's a base hit from Junie Panda. So now one on with one out for Buckley, who hits a hard ball to right field, and there'll be another hit. Junie will advance to third. So now runners on the corners with one out for Jay Kane. That ball is through the hole for a base hit. And first and third again. So Supernova's trying to make the over hit, I guess. They saw that I bet on the over. Red Arrow is going to beat that out for an infield single. And that ball will get away from the catcher, and a run will score. The second hitter, Crashwagon, will be out, but 4-0 Supernovas. And six hits through an inning and a half.
Esposito with a high fly ball into left center field. Not quite enough juice on it. Left fielder Buckley going to take care of that one. LaFleur going down on strikes. So Nutt rings him up with the circle change. It's a quick two outs to the inning. Watermelon Walrus, the DH. That's going to be a base hit for the future retiree. Base hit into right field. That will be a single. Grounder short over to second, and that's going to be a fielder's choice. Grounded into by Lonnie Anderson, and that's going to be out number three. So seven hits so far in this ball game. As we go to the top of the third, Nova still lead 4-0.
Bogaskew will start the inning with a ground ball to the second baseman for the first out. Next up, Torrent will draw a walk as that pitch missed the zone on a full count. Next up, Sandy Taters, as my stream freezes again, but it looks like he reached first base. And then a fly ball from Westfall. So now two on, two out for Junie Panda. Golden Glove winning shortstop will just barely be thrown out. Nice play by the third baseman there. So 4-0 Supernovas after 2.5 innings with 8 hits already.
Dom Drozdov with the ground out to shortstop. I did not realize that exclamation point stinky was a command in the chat. It's gonna crowd out as well, so that's a quick two outs as Tilapia Salmons will get a double. He'll be standing on second base. Not quite an RBI towards that 450, but a base hit and their 10th double this season, I think it said. But Ace Carter will fly out to right field, and that's going to be out number three. So the score remains 4-0 Sarasota as they look to extend it here in the top of the fourth. Uh-oh.
Buckley here will lead off the inning with a base hit. So we're already at 10 hits now.
Sorry, I paused it. My stream was buffering, so I was concerned that we had lost it again, but I think we're good.
Oh, I think it's still good for now.
Yeah, it looks okay. It was just a quick buffer. Sorry about that.
Ground ball to the second baseman here, and he will not get an out there. He kind of threw that throw to first very softly, and then a bloop hit. Will load the bases here, and that is a walk. So, walk in a run here, and the bases are still loaded for Ione Bogusky. This could be a great matchup for him here. But the Toros are going to counter, bringing in Ryan Hsu out of the pen. But Bogusky still hits this well, but not good enough. But that will send home a run. So, next up, Io Torrent. He will go down on strikes. And Taters hits this ball well. That is deep.
Wow.
And that is gone. A three-run bomb for the first baseman, Sandy Taters. Their fifth of the season. And it is 9-0 Supernovas. They're trying to get that over just on their own offense.
People are going to think we're rigging this because we're the GMs on the cast there. The teams that are offensive waking up.
Strikeout from Westfall will end the inning. I did happen to also bet the over, but
it's a fly out to shallow left. Panda takes care of it. And a fly out to center field. Esposito goes down out number two. The floor gonna ground out, and that's a quick 1-2-3 inning for Nutt on the mound for the Novas. Exclamation point rigged. Go to the top of the fifth.
Ooh, nice dive and catch from the center fielder there. Will retire Genie Panda. Ground ball to the shortstop from Buckley will make it two outs. And the nine hitter Kane up here, and he will swing and a miss. So Supernovas go down quickly here. Ryan Hsu starting to find a groove out of the pen. We head to the bottom of the fifth. Still 9-0 Supernovas.
Watermelon Walrus will lead this one off with a base hit into center field, his second base hit of the ball game, and we are very close to that threshold of 15.5. Anderson is going. Wait, what was that? He was out at first. Okay, it said he's safe on the feed. I got really confused. I was like, he was waiting first base forever. How is he safe? Fly out into left field for fitted first and second for Tilapia Salmons. That's gonna be RBI career number 446 and number 447, maybe. Yep, safe at home is Drozdov. That's gonna be two RBIs for Tilapia Salmons on the double. Ace Carter is gonna ground out to end the inning. Toros creep a little bit closer, putting it at 9-2. Let's go to the top of the sixth now.
Top of the order here, Red Arrow will draw a four-pitch walk to start the inning. Next up is Crash Wagon, another walk, so now maybe starting to lose control. So a new pitcher, Dasani Voss, will come in. He's facing Bogusky, and Bogusky will drop one into left field. So now bases loaded, no outs for Io Torrent. That is right at the second baseman, and that is a hard-hit double play ball. But a run does score, and now 10-2 Supernovas. Taters will ground this one back at the pitcher, and that will retire the side. So after loading the bases, they only do get one run, but they're still up by eight, and we are at 16 hits.
Yeah, so we got, so the over has already won it, and Bauer just tacks on another hit, as that's home run number 5 on the season for Anthony Bauer, 454 feet on the solo shot by the Cancun Toro first baseman, and the co-GM for the Toros as well. Bauer's going to put the lead at 7 now instead of 8. Esposito will fly out to right. That's out number 1 on the inning. LaFleur with a high fly ball into right field, but that's taken care of as well by Bogusky. Walrus the DH already with 2 hits today, but he's going to pop it up, and it's going to be taken care of by the second baseman, Red Arrow, for out number 3. So the Toros put the lead at 7 now, 10-3 as we go to the top of the 7th.
And that's a base hit there. So hit number 18 from Westfall. I don't think. Oh, and another one. We're at 19 hits in the 7th inning. Ground ball back to the pitcher, and they will only get one. So now, first and third for the 9 hitter, Jay Kane. Oof. And was that a pass
a
ball
wild
or wild pitch? That'll score a run. And there's ball 4 to Kane. So now back to the top of the order, and Arrow's been swinging the bat well today. And here Castillo's in the pitch, and he will retire Red Arrow. So maybe telling me to not talk about his success. And Crash Wagon will also get down on strikes. But a run does score in 11-3.
I love the nicknames. Babs pointed out literally Joey Gallo, and then in the feed it popped up with Alex Johnson's father goes down swinging. That's Red Arrow's nickname, for those of you who don't know. Dom Drozdov, the right fielder, is going to go down on strikes for out number 2 here after Anderson went down, I believe, on a ground out. Michael Fitted is going to return to the dugout as well, and that's a 1-2-3 inning for Nutt, who is still in the game here in the bottom of the 7th and puts up a 1-2-3 frame. Going to the top of the 8th now.
So, literally Joey Gallo back up. He will reach first on a walk. Taters here. That is a double play. That will end the inning. Supernovas like to hit into double plays. This is a trend I've noticed a lot. But they're still up 11-3 here.
Tilapia Salmons is going to ground out to first baseman Sandy Taters, who takes it himself. Ace Carter ground ball back to the mound. Nutt throws on to first for out number 2. Anthony Bauer with a line drive into right center. It's going to get past both of the outfielders, and he's going to be safe at second with a double. That might be the day for Buster Nutt. We'll see. No, he's still got actually quite a few pitches. Oh, yep, it is. Greg Maddux Jr. will come in to pitch in relief as Esposito takes a walk to first base. Peter LaFleur with runners on first and second and 2 outs is going to get a base hit. That's going to score at least 1. And the runners will be at first and second with 2 outs now for Watermelon Walrus. Already 2 hits on the day. As Cancun scores their 4th run there. Puts the Supernovas lead back to 7. But Walrus is going to fly out into shallow right. And that's going to be out number 3. So we go to the top of the 9th. Novas with the last chance to extend the lead.
Westfall will go down strikes to start the top of the 9th here as Thomas Corcoran in for the Toros. And that ball is hit pretty well from Junie, but it didn't have the distance as it's caught a few feet short of the track. And the 9-hitter, or 8-hitter, excuse me, Buckley with a sharp ground ball to the shortstop who can't corral it, and he will reach base. And another hit from the 9-hole, Jay Kane. So now 2 on for Red Arrow here, trying to add on, but he will go down on strikes. So now up by 7, Supernovas look to hold this lead heading into the last frame.
And we talked about the career RBI milestone for Salmons. If 3 people get on here and Salmons gets a home run, he will hit that 450 RBI mark for the career as Lonnie Anderson gets on with a single. No, trust, I was going to go yard. 2-run home run off of Greg Maddux Jr. to put Cancun up to sixth. Very unlikely Salmons hits that 450 RBI mark now. He needs three on the career for that. Michael Fitted will get a base hit into right field, and that will bring up Salmons himself. 11-6 is the score with no outs still, but a grounder second will put two outs on the board as Salmons grounds into the double play. Ace Carter high fly ball into right field, and that's pulled down by Bogaskew, and that's going to be game over. Supernovas win this one 11-6, out hitting the Toros 15-11. Despite for all the hits that the Supernovas had, Toros also put up several with 11 on the day. Three RBIs for Sandy Taters on the side of the Novas, two for Bogaskew, and three hit days for both Buckley and Kane at the bottom of the order for Sarasota. On the side of Cancun, we got two RBIs for Tilapia Salmons and Dom Drozdov, and multi-hit games for Bauer, Fitted, Salmons, and Walrus. Nutt gets their first win of the season for Sarasota, going 7.2 innings, giving up four runs on seven hits. Nacho Varga takes their fourth loss, unable to get any further than three innings, giving up eight runs early on. Eno Bogaskew is your player of the game, going 2 for 3 with two ribbies and one run across the plate today.
I'm gonna have to leave the stream now, but
Okay.
glad I could check out some baseball and end it with a Supernovas win.
Yeah, no kidding. Well, have a good night, Red Arrow. Thank you for joining me on the cast tonight.
Oh yeah, thank you for having me, and good luck the last couple days.
Thank you. Anytime, anytime, yeah. All right, so it's just me the rest of the way. We got one more game, and then we got 2 days of quick sims. So we'll try and get through those fairly quickly today. I think we started almost 2 hours ago, so we're actually on pretty good pace. So we'll fly through these box scores here as the Vandals complete the sweep of the Apex 5-2. Scheider-May, instrumental in the team's 5-2 triumph. We'll take a look at his day in the box score here. It looks like, oh wow, a grand slam in the bottom of the fifth by Scheider-May. 3 for 4 at the top of the order with those four RBIs all coming from the Grand Slam. Sam Andrews also having a multi-hit game, 2 for 3. And it looks like Zach Lodge had a solo shot in the sixth inning as well. Apex had a 2 for 4 game from Ben Dover and a 2 for 3 game from Big Chungus. Winston also putting another RBI on the board for Indy. Shifty Lagoose gets the loss, falling to 2-1 on the season. Dion actually a pretty good day in relief, three innings of shutout ball as well. Kai gets the win for Vancouver, improving to 3-3 on the season. Pressing and Kidd both get holds, and Fuji gets their fifth save. I don't know why he keeps getting put in at the end of the game. I have Kidd set up as the stopper. It's weird. Scheider-May with the player of the game though. And we're gonna be checking out other games around the league here. Voyagers will put another loss in the Aviators column here. Aviators have been having a really hot start to the season, but Voyagers are gonna take this one, bringing the Aviators to 19-5. 1-0, the final score. They got the Voyagers got a solo home run by Eric Rivers in the bottom of the first, and then nothing else happened in terms of runs for the rest of the game. Rivers being that one RBI on the day. Delisio, the only batter in the game between both teams to have a multi-hit game. Bob Beaumont takes their first loss of the season for Outer Banks. Joey Slothface gets the win, six shutout innings. Sutherland and Lemieux get holds, and Graves gets the save, as Joey Slothface is the player of the game. Bubs. Ah, man. Supernovas Toros was the game we watched, so we'll skip that one. Rougarou over the Crabs are going to win it 7-5. Crabs actually out hit New Orleans 11-10. Two RBIs for Brew and Johnny Times 2, as well as Alejandro Geronimo. Two hit games as well for DeStefano Jr. and Beauregard. Providence with a 4 for 5 game from John Dowd, the catcher. Two RBIs for Dowd. 2 for 4 game for Al Bundy as well. Whole Horse takes the loss and the blown save for Providence. Salchicha gets their third win for New Orleans, and Chadwick gets their fourth save. Johnny Times 2 is your player of the game. Raptors will spill this loss 8-4, out hitting them 14-7. This game was 6-1, it looks like, in going into the ninth. So a 5-run lead. Oh no. Yeah, 5-run lead extended to 7, and then this loss came back for 3 runs in the bottom of the ninth. 3 RBI game for Tomato Turtle, with a 3-run home run in the bottom of the ninth. Only other RBI coming from San Antonio at the top of the order for San Antonio. Boise has multi-hit games from multiple players. Finn Reese, Iso, McDavitt, Pluto going 3-for-4, and Blon at the bottom of the order there. McDavitt with 3 RBIs and Iso with 2. Waller gets the win for Boise, improving to 2-2 on the season. San Antonio has Billy Greer taking their first loss, unable to get out of the fifth. Jackson Waller with the player of the game honors, with that solid start on the mound for Boise. Nashville Stars will take down Kashima here, 1-0. 3 hits each for both the teams. A low-hitting game. The 3 for Nashville coming from Fry, Rose, and Meredith, with Fry getting the 1 RBI of the game. Valor, Hunter, and Dawson Jr., the batters that got hits for the side of Kashima. Scotty Omega gets their first loss of the season for the Foxes. McFlorida Man gets the hold, and Hammersmith gets the save. But it's Barack Obama, who's your player of the game, with a 7-inning shutout start, giving up only 3 hits and a walk, and striking out 9. Excellent start by Barack Obama. Death Valley Scorpions will take down the Detroit Demons here, 10-1, on the back of a 4-run 7th inning. Looks like a 3-run homer by Ian Fullman in that 7th versus Thomas Palmer. The only RBI for the side of Detroit coming from Charlie Law Jr. Multi-hit games, though, from Knox, Dimes, and Danny B. On the side of the Death Valley Scorpions, 4 RBIs for Ian Fullman on the day, 3-for-5. I think that's a good shot at being the player of the game right there. 3-for-5 as well for James Love. RBIs as well from Fart, Sim, and Alderson. Justin Sims gets the win, their first of the season for Death Valley, going 7 innings, giving up only 1 run. Kid Carsey gets their third loss of the season for Detroit, giving up 5-for-4 innings, and Ian Fullman is your player of the game. That's going to do it for the majors, and we'll head on down to the minors here. Armadillos are going to take down the 66ers. Dillo Dillo in the chat, 5-4 is the final, as the Dillos improve to 15-10. Looks like a 3 RBI game on the side of Amarillo for Sacco the Taco, 2-for-4 ball game. And Shapiro, 3-for-4, as well as Spock, 3-for-4. San Bernardino gets 2 RBIs from Miles Ahead, and a 3-for-4 ball game with a 1 RBI for Badambushi. Dirk Diglett will take their first loss for the 66ers, giving up 5 runs over 6.1. John Barron gets their third win for Amarillo, 4 runs over 7 innings, and Dylan Arms gets the save. Sacco the Taco, your player of the game. Lemurs versus the Swifties. Swifties are going to take this one 5-2, out hitting the Lemurs 9-5. 3 RBIs for Jody Quinn, 2-for-4 ball game. Other RBIs coming from Jimmy Smith and this dude on the side of State College. Lemurs get 2 RBIs, 1 from Muckers O'Houlihan, as well as Zet Zaxon, the catcher, who had a 3-for-4 ball game. Cantaloupe Crocodile will take the loss for Louisville. That is a very interesting render. I don't think I've seen that one yet. 6 innings, 3 runs. Nico Baldelli, the win for State College, their third of the season. Laurels and Jader get holds, and T2 gets the save. Nico Baldelli is your player of the game. Get gunked, says the Kingpins, as they take down the Dynamos 8-3 on the start by Tony Gunk. Looks like 3-for-4 ball game for Pork Chop Sandwiches on the side of Chicago. Other multi-hit games include Gofford, Frank, Gray, and McCoy. McCoy picking up 3 RBIs. Dallas gets 3 RBIs, 1 each on the back of Edwards, Krustus, and AA, who had a 3-for-4 ball game. Parmalee and Krustus, also with multi-hit games, going 2-for-4 each. Giuseppe Tosin takes their fourth loss for Dallas, giving up 5-for-5. Tony Gunk gets their third win, improving to 3-1. Quality start, 7 innings, 2 runs on 6 hits. Kaladin Stormblessed gets their fourth save for the Kingpins, as Tony Gunk is your player of the game. AJ knows what's up. Why? Because it just said, because I said get gunked. I saw him on the player of the game, and I had to. Wheelers over Mounties. 4-3 is the final. Looks like it was a 3-2 ball game going into the ninth. 10-4 is the hitting. Wheelers, lots of hits. Mounties not quite as much, but the run total is very similar. Two RBIs for Mike Boss Jr., the first baseman on the side of Kingston. 2-3 ball game for Harry Stocks with a 1 RBI. On the side of Anchorage, 3-5 game for Troy Dominick, the Sarasota Supernova prospect, with 2 runs knocked in. Cesar Suave going 2-3 near the bottom of the order as well. Perry Hodder gets their third win for Anchorage. 6.2 innings, 2 runs given up. Rizzo gets the hold, and Hiro Ono gets the save. Matty DiFerrari takes their third loss of the season for Kingston, going 2 innings in relief. Perry Hodder will be your player of the game. Hepcats will take a win over the Brew City Bears 6-2, out-hitting them 9-4, each team with 1 error. RBIs for Brew City coming from Jose and left-right. No multi-hit games for the Bears. On the side of Kansas City Hepcats, multi-hit games for Caruso and Justice. With 1 RBI for Rudder Wash with Mustache, Caruso, and Santana Cruz, while Vladimir Batista picks up 3 RBIs on one swing of the bat. Looks like a bases clearing double in the fourth inning off of Thomas Thursday. Bark Merle gets a win for Kansas City, their third of the season. 8.1 innings, giving up only 1 earned run. Excellent outing for Bark Merle, who is your player of the game, by the way. Thomas Thursday gets their fourth loss for Brew City, giving up 3 earned runs in 3.2 innings. And that will do it for the 21st of May. Going to go ahead and finish today and move into May 22nd. We do have one game to show you today, and that's going to be New Orleans versus Vancouver. Go ahead and give you some stat team info. Let's see here. Let's probably go into the actual matchups first. Let me do that. Looks like New Orleans has the advantage everywhere except for the first two positions in the lineup, where Lodge and Sessions have it over Beauregard and Cook. Taking a look at the stats, New Orleans versus Vancouver, Alex Johnson will be pitching for the Vandals, my player. He's 2-2 with a 2.70 ERA, which I think went down, maybe? Yeah, 2.68, but close enough. And he's on pace for the best season of his career. Well, I'm just waiting for the other shoe to drop, really. Coco McQueen is 2-3, 2-3, excuse me, with a 6.47 ERA with 9 home runs in 32 innings. He's on pace for the worst home runs per nine of his career. Ace closer James Pleasance is 1-1 with a 2.38 ERA. Unfortunately for New Orleans, he has blown both of his two save opportunities. Geronimo Scheidermay is the only Vandals hitter batting above 250 as of this writing. He is a 289 hitter as a career 226 hitter. It will be interesting to see if this year he's finally going to break out, or if the Vandals will have anyone bat above 250 this season. This is the first meeting between these teams this season, both in series and in game. This will be the first game of a 3-game series. Everyone, take a look at those predictions. How many runs scored total in the sixth inning, specifically over or under 1.5? I'm gonna say over. Vales hit pretty well recently against the Apex, so maybe they'll hit pretty well here. We'll see. But just in the sixth inning, 1.5 is the over under. We'll see where we get there. I know the stat team had said that Scheidermay was at 280 something for batting average. He's now at 308. He's been having a really good season for the Vandals. On the side of the Rougarous, it looks like the best hitter so far has been Johnny Times 2 with a 299 batting average, but Naz Ahmed and Alejandro Geronimo are not too far behind, both sitting around 280-ish. Babs put 4K on the over but meant to do the under. No, Babs! Submissions are closed. 58% of you say under 1.5. 42% say over 1.5. I'm saying over. We'll see where we get on that one. But I can't predict. I can just say and go back and prove via the VOD. But hopefully I won't need that. No one will call me out, right? It's going to be the Rougarous starting off against starting pitcher Alex Johnson. It's going to be top of the order, Gustav Beauregard, J.R. Cook, and Slithery Snick leading off for the first inning here. In the top of the first, Beauregard will be issued the free pass to first on the 3-1 count. Not a great start for Johnson. J.R. Cook will be issued a walk as well. That's two back-to-back walks. No, stop it! Stop it! Johnson has loaded the base with walks and a quick grounder to shortstop, over to second for one, over to first for two, so a quick double play. Paolo DiStefano Jr. will fly out to center field to end the inning, but the Rougarous will score a run on the double play ground ball after Johnson loads the bases with walks. No! Ask the booth, I've heard Alex Johnson's user stinky is this true? Well, I don't know. I showered today. Zach Lodge will ground out to first for the first out of the bottom of the first here. Herb Sessions high fly ball into right field, taken care of by Paolo DiStefano Jr. Zach Mouse will be up to bat next, and that will be a flyer into left field, taken care of by Johnny Times 2. So 1-2-3 inning for Coco McQueen as we go to the top of the second now. Johnson is a bum. Yeah, certainly. And he's back on the mound, too. Christopher Brew will go down on strikes for out number one. It's going to be Johnny Times 2, then Naz Hamed to lead off this inning. And that's going to be base hit all the way down the right field line. And that's going to be a double for former Vandal Johnny Times 2, getting their 10th double of the season off of former teammate Alex Johnson. Naz Hamed will get a base hit. Throw comes to the plate, and that was there a mile ahead of Johnny Times 2. McMuffin throwing out former teammate at the plate. Oh, that's going to be a home run by Alejandro Geronimo, and New Orleans is now up 3-0, 379 feet from home plate. Just barely clearing the wall, it says. Alejandro Geronimo, the center fielder, getting a two-run homer and putting the Rougarous up 3-0 now. Quick grounder at first base, and that's out number three. Remember how I was saying, waiting for the other shoe to drop with Johnson's good season? This might be it. I don't want to jinx it, but Toby McMuffin is going to go down on strikes. McQueen's circle change, sending him back to the dugout. That's out number one, brother to brother there. Lunchbox McGrath, the DH. That's going to be a long fly ball into left field. That one's gone. It says just inside the foul pole, but I think that was a little bit further in than just inside. 377 feet, the solo shot by Lunchbox McGrath. New Orleans is still out in front, but the Vandals are going to close that lead, making it 3-1. Geronimo Scheider-May with an excellent start to the season. He's going to ground out to second base for the second out of the inning. Bob Gibbles. Grounder to third, over to first, and that is going to be out number three. So the Vandals pick up a run on the solo shot by Lunchbox McGrath. And Rougarous still have the lead 3-1 as we go to the top of the third. They're looking to extend it against Johnson here. J.R. Cook up to bat first, and he's going to go down on strikes. Slithery Snick, second up here. Grounder to Johnson, who throws on to first. Oh, barely out. I thought he had a chance there for the infield hit, but just barely gets thrown out at first. Richie Bonanza is going to fly out to center field, and Johnson might have found the groove here. As New Orleans still up 3-1, but a 1-2-3 inning for Johnson. As we go back to the Vandals, Sam Andrews, that's going to be a base hit down the left field line, and that's going to be a double for the rookie third baseman. He's going to be safe at second there easily. Danny Gonzalez now up to the plate, center fielder. Grounder to second, over to first, and that's out number one, but it will advance the runner 90 feet from the plate. Sack Lodge checked swing, but he went around. That's going to be a strikeout for the catcher. Herb Sessions, the veteran shortstop, is going to go down on strikes as well. So the Vandals get a runner to the third with one out, but can't do anything about it. Still 3-1 for the Rougarous. Quick sim to the sixth. No, we got to watch this. Paolo DiStefano Jr. With a fly ball into right field, and that's caught for out number one. Christopher Brew is going to ground that to the shortstop. Throw on to first. Barely makes the play. Great off-balance throw by Sessions, it says. That's a base hit into right field for Johnny Times 2. Two outs, runner first. Johnny Times 2 goes for second, and he steals it. off of Sack Lodge. Naz Hamed is going to take a free pass to first. First and second now with two outs for Geronimo, who's going to get a base hit into center field. Throw to the plate, and he's going to be safe at the plate. It is Johnny Times 2, and New Orleans increases their lead now to 3. Score is 4-1. Gustav Beauregard grounder to short, throws on to second. That's going to be fielder's choice. So New Orleans still up 4-1 as we go to the bottom of the fourth now. Vandals have a shot to put a dent in this lead here. Zach Mouse is going to ground out here. Toby McMuffin is going to follow suit with a grounder to second base. Lunchbox McGrath, the DH, the only one had a home run earlier in the ballgame, but grounds out to short as the Vandals go down 1-2-3. New Orleans top of the fifth here off of Johnson, who's still in the game. Fly ball into right field. Looks like second baseman Shire May went all the way over to grab that one. And a line out to Sam Andrews will be out number two. Richard Bonanza will go down on strikes, so a quick 1-2-3 inning for Johnson there. Pretty good inning there for the bum on the mound for Vancouver. Shire May will be up first, and he's going to take a free pass to first base here in the bottom of the fifth. Bob Gibbles, grounder short, and that's going to be a ground out. Might have had a shot at a double play a bit there, but Shire May will advance to second. High fly ball by Sam Andrews. That one's gone. Sam Andrews with his fifth home run this season, and that will put a major dent in the lead here, narrowing it down to a one-run ball game. 4-3 now. New Orleans still has the lead, but Sam Andrews with a bomb to straightaway center. Danny Gonzalez, the center fielder, that's going to be a liner to center field, taken care of by Geronimo. And Lodge will go down on strikes. So on the two-run homer by Sam Andrews, Vandals make it a one-run ball game. But here's the inning that everyone cares about at the top of the sixth here. Johnson's still on the mound, so really big chance for 1.5 or more runs. And that's going to be a flyout into left field for DeStefano Jr. Christopher Brew is going to fly out to left as well, out number two. Johnny Times 2, grounder short, over to first, and that's out number three. You don't like to see that if you're the over, or if you're a Rougarou fan. But there's still a chance here for the overs to take it, as the Vandals will need to score two runs here in the bottom of the sixth. Sessions will take a free pass to first base. That's a good start for the over team. Zach Mouse will get a base hit into right field. McMuffin could get the over here with one swing of the bat. Oh, that's a wild pitch! Wild pitch by McQueen, and that will advance the runners to second and third. McMuffin's got to get that past the shortstop. That's going to be run number one. Runners at the corners with no outs for Lunchbox McGrath. He had a home run earlier in the game. Can he push the over? High fly ball into left field. Runner taken off for the plate. Safe at home is Mouse, and that's going to be the over. Two runs in the bottom of the sixth, and that will put the Vandals ahead here 5-4 as Shire May goes down on strikes for out number two. Gibbles, high fly ball into right field, taken care of by the right fielder DeStefano Jr. Over, gets it, and the Vandals take the lead here in the bottom of the sixth. Going to the top of the seventh now, Naz Hamed with a base hit into left field. Johnson still in the game, despite giving up four runs so far. And that's going to be a base hit into center field by Geronimo. Runners at the corners now. No outs here. And that's going to be a walk issued to Beauregard. Bases are loaded with no one out. And that's going to be a base hit by Cook. That's going to be at least one. And the throw is going to go to second base. Two-run double by J.R. Cook, and that will put the New Orleans Rougarou back in the lead here, 6-5. Still one-run ball game, though. Slithery Sneck with a fly ball into left field. That's out number one. Throw to the plate is not in time, as Beauregard will score from third, and Cook moves up to third base. Runner at third with one away. The Bonanza goes down on strikes. Colby Kidd has entered the game now, by the way. It's going to be DeStefano Jr. with a runner 90 feet from the plate and two away. That's going to be a ground out too short. So New Orleans retakes the lead as it's time for the stretch. Three runs in the top of the seventh, 7-5 now the score. We go to the bottom of the seventh. Vandals, Sam Andrews is going to be up to bat, already with two hits today, but he's going to fly out to right for out number one. Danny Gonzalez, the center fielder, quick grounder to the right field. Or sorry, to the first baseman, to the right side was what I was trying to say. And a fly out to left for Sack Lodge will be out number three. Why did we not pull Johnson? That is an excellent question. Christopher Brew will go down on strikes to Colby Kidd. That's out number one here in the top of the eighth. Johnny Times 2 will go down on strikes as well. Out number two. Base is empty and two outs for Naz Hamed, the third baseman. High fly ball into left center, and that's going to be taken care of by Danny Gonzalez. So that'll be out number three as we go to the bottom of the eighth. New Orleans still leading 7-5. Vales have a shot to close the gap here with Herb Sessions at the plate. He's going to go down on strikes, and it's going to be Zach Mouse, the left fielder, who is up second here with a one away and the base is empty. He's going to go down on strikes as well, expanding the strike zone. James Pleasance entered the game last inning, I believe, and is still dealing now. Toby McMuffin will go down on strikes as James Pleasance retires the side, strikes out the side. 1-2-3 as we go to the top of the ninth. New Orleans has their last chance to expand that lead, currently at two runs. Fly ball into left field by Geronimo, taken care of by the left fielder Mouse. It's going to be Gustav Beauregard against Fuji, who has now entered the game. And that's going to be strike three from Fuji. The cutter sending Beauregard back to the dugout. J.R. Cook will take the free pass to first base on ball four. Slithery Sneck up to bat, and that's going to be a fly out to center field. Danny Gonzalez puts that away. So the Vandals have one last shot here. Three outs to get two runs at least to tie it, three to win. It's going to be Lunchbox McGrath up to bat, and he's going to line out to the left fielder. Out number one, Jackson DeMarco enters the game in save situations. He's 2-for-2 this season. Scheider May will go down on strikes. Curveball outside corner dealing the killing blow here. And it's all down to Bob Gibbles with two outs, and the base is empty. Can he keep the Vandals' hopes in this game alive? No, that's going to be a line out to right fielder DeStefano Jr. And the Vandals will fall here 7-5 as New Orleans with a great day at the plate here against Johnson. Looked like the Vandals had a little bit of a spike downwards here in possibility, but then it was just all rougarous from that way out. two RBIs for Lunchbox McGrath and Sam Andrews on the day for the Vandals. Andrews with the only multi-hit game. On the side of New Orleans, though, multi-hit games for Times 2, Hamed, and Geronimo, the bottom of the order, really dealing at the plate today. Three RBIs for Geronimo, two for J.R. Cook, and one for Slithery Sneck for a total of six. Coco McQueen will get the win for New Orleans, giving up five runs over six innings. Pleasance gets the hold, and DeMarco gets the save. Their other shoe dropped, as we talked about. Johnson taking their third loss on the season, and that ERA starting to inflate now after he gives up seven runs in six innings, 3.62 ERA now. Geronimo, the player of the game for this one. Taking a look around the league here, Crabs will take down the Apex 4-2. Apex were leading until the top of the eighth when it just swung wildly in the Crabs' favor. They scored two in the eighth and two in the ninth. Two RBIs for Magic Homo on the side of the Apex. No one with a multi-hit game on the side of Providence. Another great game for John Dowd. Multi-hit game, 3-for-5. Bergamot Lyman, excuse me, 2-for-4. The only other multi-hit game. RBIs for Reeves, Winters, and Lemon on the side of the Crabs. Farias gets their second win of the season for Providence. Bolanos blows the save for Indy, and Dogwood Maple will get their second loss. Doug Dangley, though, is your player of the game, going six innings of shutout ball. Yeah, Johnson was due for a bad game, yeah. Yeah, it's pretty typical for Johnson. Yeah, it was Bolanos. Pashima Foxes will take down the Boise Raptors. I think was it Casey Kobe that was talking about how the Foxes have, with this win, the Foxes have won, I think, three of their four last games, I believe. So Foxes are doing pretty good recently. 6-2 is the final score here. Foxes improved to 9-16. Three RBIs for Vidal Valor, the first baseman from Kashima. Other RBIs for the Foxes include Cloudera, Sims, and Paulo Joe. Boise Raptors have a 2-4 game from Connor McDavitt and a 2-3 game from Tuukka Blahn. Two RBIs on the day, both from Johnny Pluto, the DH. Looks like a two-run double. Lucas will take their fourth loss of the season, falling to 2-4, 6 runs over 4.2. Etsuka Rune gets their second win of the season, 2 runs over 6.1 innings. Solid start from Etsuka Rune, who's going to be your player of the game. Nashville Stars take down the Outer Banks Aviators in a pitcher's duel. 1-0 is the final. Only 8 hits combined between the two teams. Let's see. No RBIs on the side of the Outer Banks, but the hits, 2 hits from Nakaya and 1 each from Bergenkin, Halen, and Hank. Nashville Stars get 3 hits only, one from Hopman, one from Rose, and one from Munson. The one from Rose being a solo shot homer in the fifth inning, that being the only run scored in the game total. Walker Kato takes their first loss of the season despite an excellent outing on the mound. Walker Kato, 8.1 innings, 1 run, 3 hits, and 1 walk. Amazing effort by Walker Kato, just unfortunately no run support. Taylor Johnson gets their fourth win for Nashville. Another excellent day on the mound as well. 7.1 innings of shutout ball, giving up only 3 hits and 2 walks. Blue Line gets the hold, and Wynn gets the save. Taylor Johnson, your player of the game, but both starting pitchers, excellent outings on the mound. Great pitching in that one. Sloss will take the win over the Voyagers. 1-0, another pitcher's duel here, it looks like. Another 8 hits only between the two teams. On the side of New York, their 3 hits come from Rivers, Menard, and Hodge. On the side of San Antonio, their 5 hits come 2 from McDonald, 2 from Dinkle, and 1 from Antonio. McDonald getting that one RBI. Looks like it was just on a single. Just an RBI single. Darren gets the win, improving to 3-0 on the season. 7.2 innings of shutout baseball. Ragnilebs Sievert, 8.1 innings, giving up only 1 run, gets their fourth loss despite an amazing effort on the mound by Sievert. Slim Dugan will get their third save by for San Antonio, and Bobby Darin is your player of the game. What is with the pitching today? Everyone's having a great game except for Johnson. What is with it? All right, Supernovas and Demons. Supernovas will take this one 6-5 in extras. Sarasota walks it off. Bruce Buckley with the walk-off run-scoring single versus Duckworth Lewis, I believe. I believe that's the first name. Yeah, Duckworth Lewis. Sarasota Supernovas will get 2 ribbies by Bruce Buckley and multi-hit games from Westfall Panda, Buckley, Kane, and Arrow. Westfall crosses the plate 3 times. Detroit, with multi-hit games from 5 batters in the lineup, Armstrong, Willis, Stack and Paper B, and Yelnats. Yelnats picks up 2 RBIs, as does Willis. B will add the fifth one. Luke Coolhand Wright will take the loss here, falling to 0-2 on the season and gets a blown save accredited to them as well. Champ McQuack blows the save on the side of Sarasota, so blown saves on both sides. And Boo Boo Chungus will get their first win of the season for Sarasota, going 2.1 innings of shutout ball in relief, giving up only 1 hit. Domingo Poza, though, is your player of the game, 6.1 innings, giving up only a run. Johnson's a bum. I know, I keep saying Johnson's a bum. Death Valley Scorpions will win this one 7-1 over the Toros. 9-6 out hitting Cancun. 3 RBIs from Willie Colon on a 1-for-3 game. Was that a that was a bases clearing triple? I thought that might have been a homer, but no. Bases clearing triple by Willie Colon, knocking in 3. 3-for-4 by Elliot Alderson with an RBI. Stretch McGibbon will tack on 2 more. Cancun, 2-for-3 game by Michael Fitted. 1 RBI from Ace Carter, though, is the only RBI on the side of the Toros. Urquidez Garcia, excellent outing on the mound, improving to 4-2, 8.1 innings, giving up only a run on 5 hits and 2 walks. Callaway Flowers, Falls to 0-6 with their sixth loss for Cancun, giving up five unearned runs and one earned over 4.2. Urquidez Garcia is your player of the game. And that's going to do it for the majors. We're going to head down to the minors, see if we have any games down there. We do. Also, I apologize if I'm clearing my throat a lot. My voice is starting to go here. Luckily, we only have quick sends the rest of the way. Dynamos will take it over the Kingpin 6-3. Chris Jacob going 3-for-5 on the day, the center fielder for Chicago, crossing the plate twice. Scary Terry and Alex Frank also with multi-hit games. Dallas Dynamos have a 3-for-5 game from Giannis Christus, and a 2-for-3 game for Keenan Keeling crossing the plate three times. Double A and Barry also have multi-hit games, and Barry with four RBIs, a run-scoring single, run-scoring double, and a two-run home run. He was a triple shy of the cycle. Triple shy of the cycle for Dallas Dynamo Andrew Barry. Great game at the plate for him. Knight Rider will get the W here for Dallas. A quality start, two runs over six innings. Wheatfall will get the hold, and Barry B. Benson will take their first loss of the season for Chicago. Three runs given up over five innings. Not a bad start. Andrew Barry will be your player of the game. Yeah, Babs, do you want to hop in and read some scores? Let me send you an invite here. Let's see. Oh, Beeb's offered too. Here, let me start a voice call with you here, Babs. Sorry, Beaver. I saw Babs's offer first. Oh, while we're waiting for Babs to get set up, we'll continue on. Looks like the Lemurs and the Swifties will win this one 5-0, off the back of a three-run bottom of the sixth by State College. Two RBIs by Ernie Harwell, the catcher, and multi-hit games for Quinn, Dude, Harwell, and Blammo on the side of State College. Louisville will get a multi-hit game by Makarzu Houlihan, but no RBIs. Warner gets the loss, their second of the season for Louisville. Five runs over 5.1. Trent Bolt Jr. gets their fifth win, improving to 5-0. Seven innings of shutout ball by Bolt Jr. of State College. He's going to be your player of the game. Hey Babs, you there?
Yeah, I'm here. I'm here.
Oh, okay. Wow, I can barely hear you. Hold on.
Is my mic really low or something?
Yeah, it's something. My output's low too. Let me pull that up. Say something again.
Test.
Okay, it's still kind of low for me.
Let's see if I have. Looks like I have my. Hang on a sec. Seems like it's really low. I don't know what to do though. I can't figure it out.
Yeah, I don't know. That's too bad. It's just really, really quiet. So,
Does that help at all?
oh, that's much better. Yeah.
I'm just like holding it to my face.
can you see the screen? Okay.
Yeah, I can see the screen now, yep.
All right. You want to go ahead and do the Wheeler's Malleys here?
Yeah, sounds good. Here we go. Wheelers Mounties. And the Wheelers take this one 8-6. Looks like big days batting from Franco on the Anchorage side, 2-for-4 with four RBIs. And three RBIs for Washington on the Kingston side. On to pitching. Toasties with the win, improving to 4-2, only giving up 2 over 5. Roach with the save. Riddle gets the loss. Tough start there for Riddle. Wander Franco is your player of the game.
Bruce City Bears will take down the Kansas City Hepcats 4-3. Hepcats have a 3-run top of the eighth, but nothing else. Two RBI game for Gilmore Tuttle going 2-for-4. Left right going 2-for-4 as well. RBIs from him as well as Jose. Hepcats have two RBIs from Junichi Kaneda and one from Ernie Witt and a multi-hit game from Rudder Wash with a mustache. Kiwi Mace takes their fourth loss of the season. Seven innings, giving up three earned runs. Actually a solid start, despite the loss. Ian the Igloo will get the win for Bruce City. 5.1 innings of shutout ball. Ginsburg gets the hold, and Gooser gets the save, their second of the season. Ian the Igloo is your player of the game.
And we have the 66ers and the Dillos. It's just taking a second here. Dillos win 6-5. three-hit day from Pretzelman on the 66ers side. And a three-hit day from King on the Dillos side. Pitching, we have Bill the Hill taking a loss, giving up five earned over five. Not a great day for him. Mountain with the win first on the season, giving up 5-6. And is that Ahsoka Tano? Is that what I'm looking at here? I just see a Tano. three. Yeah, it is Ahsoka Tano. Three innings for the save. Dan King is your player of the game.
That will do it for the minors. So we'll go ahead and head on into May 23rd, which is all quick sims. We got that, and then we got one more quick sim day at the end. So we'll go ahead and autoplay all the games today. And we'll start off with the Crabs taking down the Apex here, 9-4. Look at that. Apex were leading 4-1 going into the ninth, and the Crabs scored eight runs in the top of the ninth to make it 9-4. Absolutely ridiculous. Three RBIs for Rusty Kuntz, two for Arno Drakenberg, and three for Philip Stein on the side of Providence. Al Bunte also tacks one more on. John Dowd with a multi-hit game. Rick Hood, 3-4 for Indy, knocking in one. Andrea Magicomo with two ribbies, and Ben Dover, 2-4 with one. Jimbo Slice also had a multi-hit game, crossing the plate twice. Michael Dion gets the hold for Indianapolis. Dogwood Maple blows the save and gets tagged with the loss. And Andre Farias will get the win for Providence, improving to 3-2, 1.2 innings of no-hit ball in relief. Philip Stein will be your player of the game.
Toros and Scorpions. Scorpions with another comeback win. Five in the bottom of the eighth. We'll get them this one as they win 8-4 of the Toros. Big day. Three-hit day from Watermelon Walrus for Cancun. And a three-hit day on the Death Valley side for Holding the Fart. Love with a couple RBIs and Cologne with three RBIs for himself. Pitching-wise, looks like neither of the starters got a decision. Shu with the blown save for Cancun. Castillo with the loss. Lung with the win, improving to 3-0 as a reliever. Vivi Zielman is your player of the game with that two earned over six inning start.
Vandals take the win over the Rougarous, striking back after the first loss of the series. 8-5 here is the final. Vandals improving to 18-8 on the season. Looks like two RBIs for Paolo DiStefano Jr. and one for Gustav Beauregard and Chris Brew on the side of New Orleans. Those three were the only ones with multi-hit games on the side of the Rougarous. On the side of the Vandals, multi-hit games for Sessions, Lodge, McMuffin, and Gonzalez. Gonzalez and McGrath knocked in two RBIs each. Gibbles knocked in three. Greg Digger Jr. with an excellent start on the mound. Quality starts, seven innings, giving up three runs on seven hits. Aiden McDougal will take the loss on the side of New Orleans. Two innings pitched, giving up seven runs. Greg Digger Jr., your player of the game. He's having a good start of the season too.
Yeah, impressive so far. Demons put the hurt on the Supernovas and win 7-1 on a 13-hit effort. Three hits for Victor Herrera at the top of the lineup, and three also for Joe Burrow at the bottom of the lineup for the Demons. The only multi-hit day for Sarasota will be Jay Kane at the bottom of their lineup. Bentley gets the win for Detroit, giving up just one over six. And Maddox will take the loss in relief, giving up four in just a third of an inning. Victor Herrera is your player of the game.
Foxes take down the Raptors 6-2, out-hitting them 10-8 at the Kitsune Dome. Two RBIs for Valor and Stud. Multi-hit games for Valor Ruiz and a 3-4 game for Paul Lowett Joe at the bottom of the Kashima lineup. Raptors get two RBIs only, both from Parker Beecham, who goes 2-3. and Connor McDavid the only other multi-hit game for Boise. Rich Evans gets their second win of the season for Kashima, going 8 innings, giving up 2 runs on 7 hits. DJ Law gets their 4th save in relief, and Bill Bisquick will take their second loss for Boise. Rich Evans will be your player of the game with that excellent star on the mound for the Foxes.
The Stars take down the Aviators in extras 4-3. Looks like Thomas Rose, they said, had the final drive in there. Multi-hit days for Nashville from Fry, Rose, and Svanberg. And the only multi-hit day for Outer Banks will be Wesley and Kia. Pitching-wise, neither starter gets a decision. Both with quality starts, though. Nien gets the win, improving to 2-0. Shut out 1 2/3 there at the back end for Nashville. And Ben Caden will get the loss for Outer Banks, giving up that losing run and just one inning of work. Ripsbaugh, your player of the game, with 2 earned over the 6 innings in his start.
And Voyagers are going to take down the Sloths here 3-1, out hitting them 10-8 on the day.
Love to see
one,
it.
3 RBIs on the side of New York, 1 each for Long, Slim, and Hodge. Menard and Iridian each gained a multi-hit game. On the side of San Antonio, multi-hit games for Antonio, Camden, and Dinkle, with the only RBI coming from Scott Poe, the left fielder, going 1-for-4 and getting a solo shot off of Kevin Choate. Choate will take the win here, improving to 4-2, giving up only 1 run over 6 innings. Miller and Lemieux get holds. Leonard Washington gets their 2nd save, and Ryan Rose will get tagged with their 5th loss of the season. Not a great start to the season for Ryan Rose. Kevin Choate will be your player of the game. Solid starting effort by the New York pitcher.
Just going to say there, I saw that I threw out Juoso at home.
Okay.
On a fact fly. Fun fact.
where does it say that?
So if you go down,
oh, yeah.
It says double play field assist Menard Antonio at home.
Great play.
It's just exciting.
Well, down to the minors now and auto sim all these games as well.
Hepcats looks like sorry, it's just taking a second to load in for me.
Oh, that's fine.
6-4 win over Brew City. Multi-hit days for lots of different people here, but most prominently looks like 3 hits for Weed M Boys, another Voyagers prospect with a great game, and 3 hits for Fabian on the Bruce City side. Down to pitching, and I'm still here. Okay, there we go. Smoltz with the win, improving to 4-0, 4 earned runs over 5 2/3. Cyrek the hold, Homie a hold, and looks like Fodia or Focia, the save. Bumbles gets the loss, giving up 5 over just 2 2/3. And Kaneda is your player of the game.
Mount up. Mounties will take this one 7-1. They're not having a great start to the season, but a good win against Anchorage here. Out hitting them 12-5. 3 RBIs on a 3-for-5 game for Harry Stocks. 2-for-4 game with 1 ribby for Fardinghouse, and a multi-hit game for Wallace Gromit, tacking on another RBI. On the side of the Wheelers, only 1 RBI, this one coming from Kylian Ray, the shortstop, on an 0-for-3 game. 5 hits scattered among 5 players for Anchorage. Busta Baxter for Anchorage will take their 3rd loss of the season. 5.2 innings, giving up 3 earned runs. Nicholas Wilson for Kingston will get their 2nd win, giving up only 1 run on 6 innings. Excellent start for Wilson. DeFerrari will get a hold, and Royd Walrus will get their 2nd save of the season for Kingston. Nicholas Wilson, your player of the game.
Dynamos and Kingpins. Dynamos take this one 6-2 on the strength of 13 hits. Looks like lots of different multi-hit games and a team effort there as everyone in the lineup gets a hit. But multiple for Kayleen, Barry Bodnar, and Hafner. For Chicago, the only multi-hit day will be Jimenez. Pitching-wise, Tam grabs their 1st win of the season, giving up only 2 over 6 2/3. McDonald with the save. Lemonade takes the loss, falling to 3-3, giving up 4 earned over 5 2/3. Casey Tam is your player of the game.
Lemurs will take down the Swifties 11-2, a blowout 19-hit affair for the Louisville Lemurs. multi-hit games for almost everyone in the lineup except for Thrallers and Zaxxon. Specifically, three-hit games for Ramirez, O'Houlihan, and Myth. Two RBIs each for English Poutine Ramirez and Ronaldinho. State College will get two RBIs only, one each from Jody Quinn and Mike Hussey. Two for four game for Jimmy Blamo at the top of the order. Cap Keeler gets their third loss for State College, giving up three runs over six innings. Not a bad start, actually. Brent Alexander, though, will get the win on the side of Louisville, giving up two runs over 5.1 innings. Davidson will get the hold, going 2.1 innings in relief. Brent Alexander, your player of the game.
And the 66ers take down the Dillos. Looks like 10-9. Very close game, high scoring affair. Lots of multi-hit days, but it looks like the big one is for the 66ers. 3-for-4 day with two runs and two RBIs for just Miles Ahead. Is that what it is?
Yep.
My screen's just a little blurry. It's all good. a couple of multi-hit days looks like for Campbell, and I can't read the top one.
Trevin Knight.
Oh, cool, 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 cool. Okay. Pitching-wise, Sullivan with the start, not a great one. 7 earned over 4 2/3, but Dot will get the win, going 3 shutout at the end of the game. Big deal there for the 66ers. The loss goes to Bunbury, who also gets a blown save, giving up 3 unearned runs in relief in just a third of an inning. Miles Ahead, your player of the game.
That'll do it for the 23rd. We got one last day, which is the 24th.
I'm wondering if this is an off day.
It's an off day for the majors. I think we have... Oh, never mind.
Simultaneous off days, yep.
it said quick sim all on the schedule, which threw me off. All right, so that's where we'll end, I guess. I want to take a look at these all-star voting here. I don't know. Oh, I mean, I want to see exactly where people are looking. I don't think it's actually... Never mind.
Yeah, I don't think you can see the voting.
Nope, you can't.
Yet.
Let's take a look at the standings, though. I want to take a look and see here. Yeah, Vandals have been on a hot streak. I don't know what's going on there, but 18-8.
We're rolling.
This is a close division, though. This is actually really close.
Yeah, the Crabs have been bouncing back, too, because I know they were, I think, even further behind than what they are now.
Crabs are improving, too. Outer Banks has been really hot. They had kind of a little bit of a
I think
slip
they cooled down a bit
season,
there.
Think,
that's
yeah.
Yeah.
5-5 in the last 10. Apex have been falling. Apex and Toros have been falling a little bit. 2-8 each over the last 10. But that's going to be it for today. We're going to go ahead and start the upload here. I'm just going to check the settings. That looks good. And that looks good as well. Well, thank you for joining me at the end here for the box scores, Babs. Much appreciated.
No problem. I thought I'd give your voice a break.
Yeah, thank you. It's I'd definitely be just probably playing songs here at the end for this upload. But I'll let you go. It's just the upload here from here on out. But thank you very much for joining me. Really appreciate it.
No problem, man. Thanks for having me.
Anytime. Have a nice night.
You too.
Oh man, like I said, we're gonna just end the stream with some music here. I'll put some music on in the background and mute my mic. I'm also gonna. I just want to say before I go mute for a second here, thank you to everyone for sticking around till the end here. Actually, it wasn't too bad of a stream here today. Looks like 2 hours 45 minutes about. Thank you everyone for sticking around. Thank you for the info stat team. You guys always make my job a lot easier. Thank you to both Babs and Red Arrow for co-hosting today. Much appreciated. And thank you, chat, for making this a fun one. I think this was probably one of the highest viewed streams that I've had in PBE. I think the viewership for PBE streams in general has gone quite a bit upwards recently, and I absolutely love it. I think that it's great that people are tuning in a lot more frequently. And I can't wait to see it continue to go on. Let me take a look at who's scheduled for next stream as well. So that you know, week two will be starting on Tuesday. It's going to be Al Gold. It's going to be Lucas Gold, AU Gold. He'll be starting us off on March 16th with sim number one of week two. This is actually kind of weird. I noticed this on the streamer schedule recently. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. We have 8 unique streamers taking the first 8 sims of the regular season. That's bonkers to me. Like, you will not hear the same voices on the stream, unless there's a co-host, but you will not hear the same host on a stream twice over the first 2 weeks of the regular season. I just thought that was kind of funny to share. But AU Gold will be taking us through week 2 sim number 1 on March 16th. So that'll be real interesting. Can't wait for that, but I'm going to put some music on in the background while this upload continues, and I'm going to mute myself, but thank you everyone for sticking around till the end. Much appreciated. I'm going to give 5 subs real quick here. Just because Vandals did really well today and I'm in a good mood. So, we'll see who gets those. DMCA free music. Oh, I don't
Out of the
know.
Park!
Pineapple belongs on Pizza 22, Boltron, Brandon Frat, Blue Dragon 943, and Hummus Cut is amazing. That's a great tag. I don't know who that is, but that's funny. We're going to hear some Out of the Park. I don't know what DMCA... I don't know what music is DMCA, so I'm just going to put on some music. I mean, worst case scenario, they mute part of the stream. Whatever.
Falling too fast to prepare for this. Tripping in the world could be dangerous. Everybody circling as vultures. Negative, nepotist. Everybody waiting for the fall of man. Everybody praying for the end of times. Everybody hoping they could be the one. I was born to run, I was born for this.
Whip, run me like a racehorse. Pull me like a ripcord. Break me down and build me up. I wanna be the slip, word upon your lips.
All right, no music then, I guess. That's stupid. I gotta research some DMCA, I guess, just to see what music is. Oh man, I'm not gonna sing. My voice is shot so far today, man. No, I'm not gonna sing. My singing voice is crap anyway. Y'all wouldn't be able to recognize whatever song I'm singing. Alright, so here's what we're going to do instead. I'm going to look up DMCA music laws. Oh, DMCA free music is one of the top things. Alright, gaming music for YouTube and... Okay, there's a Spotify playlist for gaming music for YouTube and Twitch copyright free music, DMCA free. I don't see if I recognize any of these on here. So far, not recognizing any through the first 50. I don't want to put something on that's going to be, like, you know, explicit, you know? Oh my goodness. If you play copyright-free music that later becomes copyrighted, you can still get a DMCA claim? That's crazy. That makes me sad because I really like playing music on streams, especially like my own personal ones. I just listen to music in the background. Twitch unveils tool for DMCA free music, October 1st, 2020. That's interesting. Soundtracks. A lot of streamers just took down all their old VODs and started playing like parody stuff while Twitch figures it out. Interesting. You know what we need? We need someone in PvE to make a out of the park remix where it's like electronic music, but it's the out of the park guy like peppered in throughout it. Out of the park. Yeah. Pixel Polka by Kevin MacLeod. All right. We'll listen to this. Let's see what this is about. Thank you. That's it. That's the stream. I mean, I would love to get that list of royalty free music. But thank you all for sticking around until the end. That's it. Index has been updated. I'm gonna post it in the main chat. But everyone have a lovely evening. Pixel Polka for the win. Have a good night, everyone.